Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Future Friday. In today's episode, we're gonna take a look at the Hyperloop scam. So let's dive right into it. So for those of you who haven't seen my last episode, basically I'm gonna give you a very basic summary. So the idea of Hyperloop is very simple. You're gonna have a maglev train like this, and you're gonna have it in a vacuum tube. That's all there is to it, and it's gonna be faster than air travel. Basically, it's gonna travel at 1000 kilometer or 622 miles per hour compared to 500 miles per hour that is for plane, and it's gonna be cheaper than air travel, which in my last episode I specified that that's the scam. It cannot be done at that cost. It can be done, it's just the cost where no matter what you do, it will be that cheap. So let's look into the biggest name in the business, Hyperloop One. So far, they are the most advanced in this field, simply because by the fact that they are the only one who has actual full-scale 500 meter test track. So they are the only one who achieved full scale, and as you can see, their track length is kind of small. 500 meter is way too small, and they already got green lit by many countries, and this was my fear that politicians, uninformed politicians might waste taxpayers' money. So as of now, USA, India and Dubai has greenlit Hyperloop One to make tracks, not to do feasibility study, to already make the track. So yeah, in India, Maharashtra CM is spearheading this progress, and Mumbai to Pune is the target. So how does Hyperloop One works, because there are many designs for Hyperloop, so we have to narrow things down. So Hyperloop One is supposed to be above ground. They are not going underground, so they are trying to avoid it as much as possible, simply because tunnels are not free, nor they are quick, nor they are cheap. So even with all those people who are like boring company is making it cheap, 10% of $1 billion per kilometer is still $10 million per kilometer. So suffice to say, it's not cheap, and even if you can make it very cheap, you still have to spend time. Time is money. Like, let's say to dig a few 10 or 100 kilometer tunnel, it takes 100 kilometer tunnel will take way too long. So suffice to say, these companies trying to flat out avoid it. They want to be above ground as much as possible. They're gonna be making a vacuum tube, and no, it's not low air pressure. They're trying to achieve full vacuum, but physics wouldn't allow you to achieve full vacuum. So their target air pressure is 1000 bar. Basically, the altitude would be more like if you are at 200,000 feet altitude. Basically, it's almost reaching space. So they're trying to go full vacuum. And how does it actually work? Now, this is the part where so many people are falling for the scam, is that they're gonna use passive maglev. In my last episode, I specified maglev is very expensive per kilometer. So everybody thinks like there is some magic thing which allows them passive maglev. There is no such thing as passive maglev. They are just changing the name. So what these people are using, it's called electrodynamic suspension. There are electromagnetic suspension, and there is electrodynamic suspension. Now, how Hyperloop One achieves it is they have permanent magnet and they have linear electric motor. Now, the forward speed is coming from linear electric motor, and using that forward momentum and mixing that with permanent magnet, they are getting the levitation. So yes, they can remove linear electric motor from many parts of the track, and during those part of the track it's just gonna hover, not hover, whatever, it's gonna coast. So the reason why I don't like that idea is simply because if you're, for any reason, you apply emergency brake in that section where there is no linear induction motor, you're stuck unless you have a battery and power to move it. And the method that they are using needs wheels for low speed, as you can see in all their YouTube video, and they're gonna be point to point. Now, this is very crucial. This I was worried about this, and I thought like it would be way too expensive to have multiple stations along the path. So they're going point A to point B, so there will be no in between breaks. So this is the proposed design that they're gonna go for, where you have Hyperloop coming from one end. They will go from airlock, they will get depressurized, depressurized basically, and then they're gonna circle around and then go to the vacuum tunnel again. So they're gonna have the airlock in this regard place. They will have the airlock, and tracks will go this way. So let's look at the cost. As I already mentioned, that we could make Hyperloop today if we had the money, and it won't be cheap. So it already is more expensive than plane. And the Mumbai to Pune route that they are targeting for, the primary studies has been done, and I will not provide you guys link. Please look it up, because if I do that, they're like, this study is wrong, this study is wrong. I keep getting that kind of message in Reddit. So look it up for yourself. And the ticket cost is 10,000 rupees. Now, if you are not familiar with rupees, don't worry about it. Just focus on the number. The plane ticket for that same distance is 4,000 to 3,000. Now, of course, it fluctuates. If you're booking, you know, last minute, of course, it's going to cost more. But more or less, it's not cheap. As I already mentioned, there is no way they could make this cheap. And then there is Dubai to Abu Dhabi that they are also greenlit. It's 1000 AED. Basically, it's more or less 10,000 rupees. It's idiotically expensive, suffice to say. And the pod, each pod, because it's not a train, you cannot attach multiple pods to it. The pod, so far, the data I got on that is it will carry 12 to 80 people. Now, 12 people, this is one-to-one scale model that they showcased. And as you can see, it's a luxury car. Flat out, it's a luxury vehicle. That was my whole point. Like, we can make it, it just won't be cheap. So I'm kind of happy and sad at the same time. I'm happy that Hyperloop One knows that they cannot make it cheap and they are not deceiving anyone. I'm just sad that people still think Hyperloop would be the, you know, next mode of transportation. Yes, it will allow fast travel, but again, at a cost that nobody can afford, what's the point? It's like, basically, we are at the same point as Concorde. It could travel supersonic, but it was too expensive. And I'm not sure how they're gonna fit 80 people in this. So, they might make pods longer, but then there is an issue that they can't turn it. And as you saw, they want to have a circular platform. So, suffice to say, flat out, as of now, all the details that we have, they are not even aiming for a middle class price. They are aiming for upper class people that can afford it. Because as you can see, Mumbai to Pune route, it's not that far. Basically, if you travel by road, not in a straight line, travel by road, the distance comes up to like 160 to 180 kilometers. So suffice to say, it's not cheap. Now, even with all that, you know, things that is almost everybody acts like it's ready to be deployed. Like, you know, we just have to go out there and, like, you know, get it done. They still haven't shown us how they're gonna do the life support system. Now, I think there is they are trying to avoid life support system simply because if you are in a cabin, like the cabin size that they have, you can have the ambient air should provide enough oxygen for like 10-20 minutes or half an hour. But they have to have oxygen generators, like how your planes have the mask. They have to have that. Otherwise, if your pod got stuck for any reason, emergency brake or anything like that, you're gonna suffocate to death or get carbon dioxide poisoning. And they still haven't shown how they're gonna have emergency exit, which they do mention in their Q&A and frequently asked questions, but they are not showing how you're gonna, you know, remove passengers that are stuck in a pod. So I really want to know that part. Cost per kilometer is still up in the air. And power consumption, one thing you have to understand, the power consumption people would be very low on the pod level. The pod will take very low amount of kilowatts. Basically, the linear accelerator, they are only few kilometers long, so it's going to take very small amount of energy. However, this is the pump that they are using for 500 meters. So suffice to say, that pump has a very significant energy consumption. So power consumption wise, I'm still not sure how much they're going to consume, and that will affect the final price of the ticket. And this part, everybody kind of ignores, that planes don't last very long for one very simple reason. Because if you go from sea level to high altitude, your material, whatever it is, whether it be carbon fiber or metal, it fatigues, it expands, and then when you come down again, it contracts. That causes very serious microfracturing, sometimes flat out fracture, and sometimes rupture of the pod. So because this pod is going from sea level to full-fledged vacuum and at a very quick rate in the airlock, how long they're expecting the pods to last? Because if you buy let's say a jumbo jet, the company will tell you this is rated for let's say 10,000 cycles. Basically 10,000 times you can go up and down. So there is no detail on that, and I'm not sure that pod's gonna last as long as they think. And why the heck, if they have 1-to-1 ratio seating demonstration, 1-to-1 test track, why the heck to this day they only have unmanned testings? Like, the when CM went there and he's like, you know, I saw the live demo, I'm like, did anyone ride in it? How the heck a people moving service can say it has a live demo when it's not moving people? Like, what? So suffice to say, if I give you a summary of this whole project, it can be done, but it's going to be very expensive. And early reports are already starting to come in that it's going to be at least 3 times more expensive than aircraft. And that is optimistic. Now, by when you can have Hyperloop in your town or country or wherever, yeah, 2021 is the targeted year for Hyperloop one. Will they achieve that? Unlikely, idiotically unlikely. So I wanted to make a follow-up to my last video. Many people commented very weird things, like that passive maglev thing, like they're gonna dig tunnels, as in like tunnel is free or something. And so suffice to say, this company is the most out there and ready to deploy, basically. And they themselves are like, yeah, the ticket cost is not gonna be cheap. So please learn from this. Please stop your counties to county, country, state, stop them. Otherwise you will end up wasting so much money, and all you will have at the other end will be a white elephant, something that is too expensive to discontinue, something that is like too expensive to actually run, and something too useless. So suffice to say, this was my presentation. I hope you guys liked it or learned from it. In that case, leave a like. If you didn't, dislike, leave a comment, subscribe, and press the bell icon to be notified, because I make video every day. And as always, thanks for watching.